Hello there, how are you all? My dear students, I expect that you are all fine and you are not wasting your time and you are preparing for your upcoming SSC exam. This is Roxana Parveen, Senior Lecturer, Department of Biology, Mileystone College. Welcome you to have this online class and I expect that you will all enjoy the class from animal reproduction. Interestingly, this animal reproduction portion is all about human reproduction. We'll get to know the fertilization, types of fertilization, embryonic development in mother's womb, formation of fetus, and after the fetus formation, we'll know the overall development of the fetus and the roles of hormone associated to the difficulties and other issues. Okay, my dear students, today's topics are fertilization in animals, basic significance of fertilization, roles of hormones in human reproduction, embryonic development, and roles of fetal membrane or placenta. Now you need to know the fertilization and its concept. What is fertilization? This is the spontaneous and autonomous process, natural process in sexually reproducing organisms to unite ovum and sperm or female gamete or male gamete to produce diploid zygote. You see, I have written twice N, haploid and haploid twice N. Okay, in animals there are two types of fertilization, external and internal fertilization. What is external fertilization? External fertilization means the gamete unite outside the body, not inside the body. Okay? And what is internal fertilization? Internal fertilization is the fertilization where the sperm travels to the ovum inside the female reproductive system of animals, and fertilization occurs inside the body of the female animals. So these are the, you know, fertilization types. So you must know the examples too. The roles of reproductive hormones in humans. As you can see in the diagram, that human brain has the special part which is called hypothalamus. From hypothalamus, pituitary gland give the necessary amount of hormones, which are called releasing hormones and master hormones. This gland is called pituitary gland or master gland. You know, the master gland secretes different hormones which have overall impact on adrenaline glands, secreting the, you know, different hormones from ovaries and testes. Okay, and they have also roles in growth and development of the growing fetus. The elaborative form of the importance of different hormones. So let's get started with growth hormone or GH. It is known as somatotropin hormone too. It is basically a protein hormone having 190 amino acids. It stimulates growth, cell reproduction, cell generation, and in boosting metabolism. It is important in human development too. What about the anterior and posterior pituitary gland? So let's know about the anterior pituitary gland for reproductive functions. At first, FSH or follicle stimulating hormone. It stimulates the follicular growth in ovaries. It stimulates the estrogen secretion from developing follicles, without which it was not possible to have menstrual cycle in the uterus or overall ovulation process in human reproduction. Next comes the LH or luteinizing hormone. Then from ovaries you see two types of important hormones are secreted. Estrogen has different functions too. It thickens, uterine lining or endometrium inhibits FSH and LH for most of cycle, stimulates FSH and LH release pre-ovulation. Progesterone, it thickens uterine lining or which is called the endometrium layer of uterus. It inhibits FSH and LH. That means it is totally reciprocal to each other. Reproductive hormones are usually made in the ovaries in females and testes in males. You already know, female reproductive hormones include estrogen and progesterone. They help developing and maintaining female sex characteristics and play an important role in the menstrual cycle, fertility, and pregnancy. What are the principal functions of thyroid glands? Thyroid glands secrete different hormones such as thyroxine hormone, triiodothyronine or T3 hormone, which help in controlling the metabolism of our body. Further, these hormones regulate weight, determines energy levels, internal body temperature, skin, hair, etc. There are some specific functions of estrogen too. You can have some notes as I told you already. There are some more information. Have a screenshot and write notes. What about the testosterone? It is a male sex hormone. This is an important anabolic steroid by nature which helps in building the body muscles. Let me explain what is steroid. Steroid means this hormone is mainly formed of fats, not proteins. In males, it plays an important role in the development of male reproductive tissues. It also promotes secondary sexual characteristics like increasing the mass of muscles and bones. Yes, this is the very important hormone which is secreted from pituitary gland after childbirth for lactation. This hormone enables female to breastfeed. It plays important roles in fertility by inhibiting the FSH and gonadotropin releasing hormone. What about the adrenaline hormone? Yes, adrenaline hormones are secreted in the medulla of kidney. It increases the metabolic rate, dilation of blood vessels going to the heart and the brain. During the stressful situation, adrenaline quickly releases into the blood and send impulses to the organs to create a specific response. Let's know something about embryogenesis. You know what is embryo? Embryo is the structure of animal's body which is formed after several cell division of the zygote, which is called cleavage. Let's know the details. What are the steps of embryogenesis? The first step of embryogenesis is obviously the formation of, blastula or multicellular mass-like structure of different totipotent cells. Yeah, it may seem like very hard, but it is not so tough. What is embryogenesis? Embryonic development starts with the fertilization of an egg cell or ovum by a sperm cell, which is called spermatozoon. Once fertilized, the ovum becomes a single diploid cell known as zygote. In this part of the discussion, we'll get to know the development of embryo or embryogenesis and how a fetus is formed from the embryo. Okay, after getting birth to the fetus can be termed as the baby. However, here is the shortcut flowchart by which you can easily understand the overall method. This is the zygote, diploid zygote. Okay, the diploid zygote goes through several mitotic cell division and finally form the embryo. Clear? And this embryo
afterwards form placenta by placentation process and finally fetus is formed in the mother's womb or uterus. This fetus grows up to the complete body of a fetus with all sorts of organs to survive in the living world. Then mother gives birth to the baby and this process ends up. Clear? So in the next part of the video, we'll get to know the every detail about the development of embryo and the fetus.
You can see the different steps occur during embryogenesis. This is the zygote which is deployed. This zygote goes through several mitotic cell division, which is called, you know, cleavage. At first it gets the multicellular structure, then it forms a layer, gradually it forms this sort of structure which is called blastula. Okay, this cap is called blastomere. These layers get more and more differentiating with the help of different cells and structures. Gradually it becomes something different and finally it starts to grow some sort of more cells by which different layers are formed. As you can see here, layer is formed here, there, okay, and finally they form three layers. Okay, so you can see the embryo is formed over there, and this is the structure showing that when embryo is formed, they get a shelter at the endometrium layer of uterus where they gradually form placenta. Placenta is formed from the membrane, special kind of this brown colored membrane, which is called the extraembryonic membrane. You know, these extraembryonic membranes finally form the placenta. Okay, so what is placenta? We got to know that placenta is the temporary but very important blood vessel filled organ, which is kind of disc shaped organ and supplies everything necessary for the growing embryo or the fetus. Look here carefully. Okay, there's the baby or growing embryo, which is called the fetus. We should not term it a baby under, you know, under this condition. We can term it a baby when they get, you know, they get the birth. Okay, after giving birth they can be termed as baby. However, you see this is the mother's uterine layer, this one. Okay, and here placenta is formed. And placenta is the disc-shaped organ which is connected to the growing fetus with the help of a channel called umbilical cord. Okay, here are some membranes of the embryo surrounding the embryo. You see one is called amnion, another is called chorion, and another is called the allantois. They have several, you know, separate functions. However, this is the, you know, zoom in portion of the embryo. And as you can see, this is the focused form of the part of the placenta. These are the blood vessels, you see, and this is the mother's body, which is called the uterus. Uterus is a part of mother's body, you know, and there is a special kind of junction in between mother's body and the placenta. Placenta takes everything necessary for the growing fetus from the mother's uterus, and excess amount of any substances from the fetus are, you know, drained through these blood vessels or placenta. So this is the very, very important organ for the growing embryo, and this determines the most of the health concerns or health issues of the growing fetus, because it also takes part in immunity. So let's know the detail about the roles of placenta in the board.
Let's know the basic importance of placenta. We got to know that this is the special temporary organ which is form the blood vessels in the mother's womb after embryogenesis. This organ is not just an organ, it plays significant roles for the growing embryo or during production of a fetus. This organ acts as the localized hormone production house too. So let's know the basic importance. So nutrient supply. Whatever the mother eats or pregnant mom eats, after digestion of the food, the amino acids, fatty acids, vitamin, minerals, all sort of nutrients, glucose, everything travels to the fetus's body. These help growth and development of the growing fetus. If mother eats less or mother suffers from malnutrition problems, the fetus also suffers from malnutrition problems. Okay, and all the nutrients travel to the fetus's body through placenta. So you know this is very important. Next is respiration. Don't the cells of the fetus produce energy? Obviously, yes. For energy production, all the cells are composed of mitochondria in the fetus's body. So for production of energy, respiration is a must. So from where oxygen comes? Obviously from mother's body. Here you go. So it helps in respiration too by supplying necessary amount of oxygen and releasing or sharing the excess gases or harmful gases such as carbon dioxide and other to the mother's body. And finally, mother's body expels them out by her own system. What's the next one? The hormonal sharing. Yes, obviously, through the umbilical cord, when placenta shares all the necessary elements, including the hormones or even enzymes from the mother's body to the placenta for the uniform growth and development. So, placenta helps to share hormones from mother's body to the fetus's body too. Due to lack of this sort of activity, the fetus might suffer from different sort of autism, that means physical autism and malnutrition problem, and even sort of different gender related problems. However, next is endocrine gland. Placenta, yes, acts as itself as an endocrine gland. It is just the alternation of the pituitary gland of human body, which resides in the particular part of the brain which is connected to hypothalamus. As because in the fetus's brain this one is not developed, the placenta acts as the endocrine gland and produces all sorts of necessary hormones for the proper growth, development and other organ formation in the fetus. Okay, what about the immunity? Yes, immunity. This is very interesting. Although this one is not pointed out at your book, however, I'm telling you that immunity, yes, placenta acts as the strange but truly ultra microscopic, super ultra microscopic barrier for the fetus to get rid of germs or infectious pathogens from mother's body. But sometimes the baby could or the infant could suffer from different problems after their birth that is not associated to this function. Okay, but immunity is also its own function to protect the fetus's body from germ infection. Even the HIV positive mother can also produce or give birth to the HIV negative baby. There is a special method by C-section. We can separate, or the specialists can separate the fetus from the mother's womb without the contamination. So this is very important question. You might answer by pointing out this specific issues.
Well, finally, we are At the termination point of the class, the homeworks are: analyze the roles of placenta in embryonic development, analyze the roles of reproductive hormones in embryonic development. Both the questions are of D standard or higher skill standard. You must follow the rules of answering those questions properly. You must follow some segments, or you have to provide enough information, including the examples or tables, charts, or any diagrams. Okay, so you must answer those questions and submit in the homework group. Okay, Allah Hafiz.